okay. First, let me say it's beauty bitch, and I've been wanting to do this for like so long. Like video blogging, I've been doing it like on my own, but like to just really like do it and post it on the net, I was just kind of waiting until the time was right. So today I'm going to talk to you guys about I'm gonna talk to you guys about this movie that I'm watching. When they couldn't get married, it was a secretive marriage because they couldn't get married legally. Well, now it has transpired over into the gay community. And they kind of do it and they kind of don't, but I guess it was for the sake of the movie that they jumped the broom because it's not legal in most states. But I watched this movie and like, it really, really, really touched me. Like for one, let's just say I did just get out a couple of bad relationships. Let's not say one, but let's just say a couple. And they went to the rocks because it was some cheating going on and faithfulness on. They were just like, you forgive and forget, right? You forgive and remember. And you just can't, like, forget that feeling or how it felt for someone to hurt you. But throughout this movie, it's like a weekend in their little private getaway home. And Wade and Noah invite Noah's friend. And like sleeping goes around, you know, like the whole I get you back because you did this to me, I hurt you, you hurt me, we hurt each other. And in the end they got married anyway. And like that really honestly truly shows longevity in a relationship. Because if you honestly truly care about a person, you'll let small things kind of big things get in the way of that. Now, I ain't saying be stupid. I'm just not, like, you know, like, if they did wrong, they did wrong. But, like, in turn, you have to know what, like, acceptable, what's something that you can deal with. You have to know your limit. You know what I'm saying? Like, everybody can't deal with a cheater. Everybody can't deal with a liar. Everybody can't deal with a killer. You know what I'm saying? So it's just like, you have to know what you're willing to go through with this person because you are in love with them. And Noah said something at the end of this movie that really just touched me near and dear, because it's like a lot of people say, oh, I love you, baby. I love this about you. And it's like, nah, that ain't real love. It's like, he said, to love you is like, no, that's wrong. Okay, let me get it right. Wait, let me get it right. He said, loving you is like giving you the world and not expecting anything in return. I love you so much that I want to give you the world and I don't expect anything in return. So if you got two people in a relationship and they both giving and receiving equal amount of love, but they don't expect this love in return, that's perfect. Close to perfect, like as perfect as it's gonna get, because y'all both giving the other person love, but you got one. I'm not gonna be giving all this love because this motherfucker probably died doing this and I doing it. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's, you don't have to, like, you have to learn how to trust. And in this movie, they trust was broken, like, completely, but they worked through it and they were willing to, like, go through the things with each other together and make it work. Because it's like they put in all their time into this, so why waste it? Like, why backtrack? Because it's too simple. So I'm asking you, how many of you out there? It's beauty, bitch.